Get your SISM training from Thor Peterson.
In this lecture, we're going to take a look at management versus governance, where you fit into the organization, some of the standards and control frameworks that our organization either have to or can choose to adhere to, and then finally, we'll look at defense in depth. It's important to remember that we all come into the certification studying from different perspectives. We have different backgrounds, we have different knowledge, and the organizations and how we are used to doing things is different. And it is very important that you answer everything on the exam from the point of view that the exam wants, not what you're used to. You are an IT security manager, you're a risk advisor, you're not a hands-on techie, you're not senior leadership, you answer everything from the IT security manager's point of view. What would that person do in the ideal organization? And now that that is clear, let's look at the difference between governance and management. Governance is senior leadership. It is the board of directors. It is the owner of the organization. It is the people who set the direction. And then it is your job as the IT security manager to figure out how do we get there. Leadership is responsible for the big picture. They make the vision. They figure out our mission for the whole organization. They decide on the policies, where you and the management team then translates that into the standards that we adhere to, the policies we have, our guidelines, our procedures, and our baselines. And we need very clear two-way communication between the leadership team and the management team, so that leadership clearly understands the risks, the opportunities, and the impacts of the direction that they have chosen, and we explain to them how are we going to get there, how do we meet the goal that they have set. So in the governance part of the organization, they go in and they look at what are our stakeholders' needs. And that could be the board of directors, that can be the owners, that could be shareholders. Regardless of who it is that we are ultimately serving, we look at what their needs are, what the conditions in the market is, the options we have. And as mentioned, they're the visionaries. They're the ones that set the direction. And they do that through prioritization of the things that we do. They make the decisions. And then when they have made them and we have implemented them, then it's their responsibility to ensure that whatever it is we have implemented is actually taking us in the right direction. They also determine our risk appetite. And this is important. And we will cover this much more in depth later. Basically, we can choose to be somewhere on the spectrum in between very risk aggressive and very risk adverse. And regardless of what we choose for our organization, any choice has unique opportunities and unique threats. If we choose to be bleeding edge, risk aggressive, well, that brings us a lot of opportunity, but it might also bring us a lot of risk. In some companies, that would make a lot of sense. In other companies, that would be a horrible decision. Regardless of what our organization is, it is not something you do. That is senior management. That is governance. You are management. As management, we plan, build, run, and monitor the activities that is needed for the organization to align with the direction that the governance body has set. And we are also responsible for our risk tolerance. That is how we're practically going to work with our risk appetite decided by senior leadership within our environment. The image over here on the right pretty much explains what I just talked about. The business needs, the board of directors, the owners, whomever has something we need to do. That is then evaluated and made into something we need to go here. They then direct us, management. We then plan, build, run, and monitor whatever it is we're doing. And that monitoring then feeds back to senior leadership so they can ensure that we are on track. This is obviously very oversimplified of how it works in the real world, but understand the flow. And when we look at projects later and when we look at change management, this will be in much more detail. But for this part of the exam, just understand the flow and why we do it and how it works together. In most places that I have worked, we have had one of two types of organization. Either we've had a bottoms-up IT security structure or a top-down. Most places are not completely black and white, but they are more of one than the other. Bottoms up is basically IT security is seen as a nuisance by the organization. We are not a helper. We do the best we can, but we don't really have senior management's approval or buy-in. And when we don't have that, well, that kind of trickles down through the organization. Many organizations are like this until they have a major security breach. Then, often, they change to a top-down. With top-down, IT leadership and management are all on board with IT security. They lead, they support, and they set the direction like they should. And this is the mindset that you need to have on the exam. Remember, the exam is perfect world. Everything is done right. Since everything is done right, we have the top-down approach that we would want. And now that we have that wonderful top-down approach, let's look at some of the roles of senior leadership, C-level executives. And remember, if you ever see ultimately liable on the exam, that is them. That is senior leadership. If you look at the image over here on the right, it is likely that above the CEO, there would be a board of directors, and maybe above them, shareholders. But just for simplicity, let's use it like it is here. The CEO, the chief executive officer, is the leader of the organization. That person can also sometimes be referred to as the president of the organization. Below the president, we have the VPs, vice presidents. And there are, in most organizations, a lot more than I have depicted here and I have in my list, but for the exam, I would know these. Normally, over the IT organization, we would have a CIO or a CTO, Chief Information Officer or Chief Technical Officer. Below that, in many organizations, we would have the Chief Security Officer or the CISO, Chief Information Security Officer. In an ideal organization and on the exam, the CSO, the CISO, does not report to the head of the IT organization. They have to report to the CEO. And we do this to make sure that no favors are played for the IT organization as far as security goes. And on the org chart over here on the right, you can see it says CEO and the C-suite are ultimately liable. You are below that square. That does not mean in any way if you do something you are not supposed to do, that you're not liable. But ultimate is the key word. You would be below that. You would be either the chief security officer, the CISO, or someone just below that, the IT security manager, or something like that. And as mentioned, there are many other C-level executives in any organization. The only other one that I think you need to know for the exam is the CFO, Chief Financial Officer. They are the money. And they're important because it's their job to make sure that the organization is financially viable. And if you can explain to them and show them whatever security implementation you're doing can save us money or potentially save us money, they can be a great ally. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to the channel. To get my courses and the free study materials, click on Learn More. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.